Kaselj from exercisesforinjuries.com. Mike Whitfield and I are outside. It's like 6 in the morning in Las Vegas, and we're gonna go through an example of a workout finisher. So I'll get Mike to introduce himself, talk a little bit about finishers, and then he's gonna take me through a sample finisher that you can do. A sample, yeah.
All right, very cool. Well, a finisher is just a great way to replace cardio intervals. Typically what we do is go into the gym, do our 5 to 10 minute warm-up, and then we go to the strength session, whether it's a split, a full body workout. But here's where everybody does the same thing over and over. We either get on the treadmill, get on the elliptical, and do our steady state cardio or our intervals. So what I want to do with my clients is replace that cardio and intervals with a finisher. Just more fun, plus you spread the energy over the entire body instead of just hitting your legs the entire time. And so it's just a great way to add a whole new dynamic, plus they're a lot shorter. They're anywhere between 3 to 10 minutes. And as a matter of fact, this workout finisher here is only 3 minutes. It's a density style. And what density means is you're going to do as many rounds as possible in 3 minutes. And here's the cool part, is each exercise is just 2 reps each. So it gives it a whole new, just kind of a cool rep and set scheme. You can really challenge yourself. So what we're going to do is we're going to do 2 jump squats, and then we're going to do 2 push-ups, and then we're going to do 2 skater hops per side. And then you just do as many rounds as possible as you can in 3 minutes. Now Rick here has volunteered to do 1 circuit for you, so he's going to join in on the madness. All right. So let's go ahead and jump into it. So jump squat. Make sure you land in the squat position. Okay. Yep, that was it right there. And then you go right into push-ups, 2 reps. And then we're going to do skater hops. 1, 1, 1, 1. That's 2 reps each, and boom, that's it. You're just doing, like I said, you're just doing 2 reps on every exercise. You just run through that as many times as possible in 3 minutes. Now, let me warn you, on paper, this looks really easy. Once you get going about 20 or 30 seconds into it, you're going to soon change your mind.
And then if you have any issues when it comes to the jump squat, Mike and I have got to go through another video of a safe way of doing a jump squat if a jump squat is difficult for you to do for your knees or your back.
Absolutely.
So Mike, where can people get more information about you?
Sure thing, you can go and check out my finishers at workoutfinishers.com, and then my blog is trainwithfinishers.com.
Awesome. So thank you very much. This is Rick Kaselj. From exercisesforinjuries.com. Make sure you head to exercisesforinjuries.com, enter your pain. There's a good chance that I have a video, article, or interview for you that's going to help you out. Secondly, if you're watching this on YouTube, head up above, hit subscribe, and what that'll do is every couple days you'll end up getting a video from myself or an interview from myself where I talk about injury and pain, or you'll end up getting a guest video from one of my friends in the fitness world. Lastly, hit down below, hit like, and leave myself or Mike a question, and we'll get back to you. So this is Rick Kaselj from exercisesforinjuries.com and Mike Whitfield from trainwithfinishers.com saying take care and bye-bye.